They're already starting.
Are we watching Aetherworks again?
No. We're watching the 3-0 matchups. What?
This is literally awful. Oh, no. He's not on combo right now. Never mind.
Yeah, what are you talking about?
I was like, dude, we're not watching Bellamarcus lose to control. Like, it's not winnable.
I was like, relax, man. I know you like your deck, but Jesus. All right, now that everybody's lost their points.
Thank you to the gal for making sure Brick saw. Appreciate it.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Now that everybody's lost their points because they wanted Wyatt to win. Here's another prediction. Good luck. If you would like to participate in a prediction. Ellie, they want to know if you've played Grease Fang yet. Would you like to inform them that you're a Grease Fang gamer or no. What?
No.
What's your favorite deck in Pioneer Go?
I don't know.
Four color doesn't exist.
Okay, yeah. I play Modern.
Yeah, she's only a Modern gamer now. Oh, for me?
Sort of.
Razor Gods 420, thanks for the follow. But I'm streaming. I don't know.
He wants to know now.
I can tell him later.
I know that place.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Dude, sit down and shut up. Man, there's a lot less channel points put on this game than there was the previous one.
Yeah, it's because Aetherworks is the best.
No, because nobody has any points to gamble.
I would gamble again.
Razor says, I love Magic. I'm glad you do, man. A lot of people have been down on Magic, so it's kind of... It's always nice to hear somebody be like, yeah, I actually like the game. So.
Bro, comma is priceless.
Yeah, you didn't know that, comma?
It's okay, Yabalski. I lost all my points, too. I'm currently back up to 110. Let's go.
Yeah, you can just type in the handy-dandy number that you want.
Which is pretty sick. Love Paper Hate Arena. True.
Does Arena extend to MTGO as well? Do you just not like online Magic? I know there's a lot of people that just like, I don't know. There's a lot of takes on that.
Right? I just don't
Some
like
people
Arena.
Don't like online. Some people hate Arena, like MTGO. Some people just are like, I want to play in paper entirely. I don't really care that there's no,
yeah,
like an online. Some people just like, that's honestly why some people were kind of thinking about Flesh and Blood a lot, because they've kind of announced that they don't want to do any online stuff. Yeah. It's only paper, which is kind of cool.
I just don't like Arena because of the economy, dude. Like, it's just so hard to switch a deck. Like, it's almost impossible without, like, spending tons of money.
I do wish there was, like, a lot more ways, like how on MTGO there's a way to rent decks, like, with programs, and then, like, you also can kind of earn some money.
Yeah.
Merp2K, thanks for the follow. TKC351, also thanks for the follow.
We appreciate it.
But yeah, the economy is pretty brutal.
Yeah, it's
Taren made a really good point. He's like, why didn't Wizards just be like the renter company? Why didn't they just take that angle?
I have no idea.
They're like, here's the economy, whatever, but you can also rent and do stuff like this from us if you want. And it's just like, yeah, man, that'd be sick. Dr. Terrier, thanks for the follow.
Appreciate it.
I just wish there was, like, a better way of, like, doing stuff. Because, like, I was playing Grixis Control or whatever, and I lost Expressive Iteration, which is fine, but, like, if the card mattered more, like, I would have just lost all of my rares and mythics. And, like, I just can't get them back. And now I'm stuck trying to grind and get something else with a deck I don't want to play.
I do think, I do think MTGO's economy would feel almost a shit ton worse if there were not rental services.
Yeah, no, it'd be unplayable.
Like, you looking at a deck and being like, gee, you tell me, I mean, we
like, if you go to the price of, like, any MH2 card for, like, Mitgo, it's crazy. Like, just go look at four colors price.
MH2 is kind of the problem. A little bit.
Yeah, no, it's not kind of the problem. It is a problem.
Well, I mean,
Go look at four colors price on MTGO and tell me it's okay.
Well, even standard cards are crazy.
Well, yeah, because they're just not drafted. That's how they get up there, right? You have to, like, draft the cards so they float around. So that way, like, the bots buy them and stuff.
Modern.
That sounds like Paper Magic is just the way to go.
Paper Magic is the way to go. I love Paper Magic. Yeah, Ragman plus Elementals are certainly expensive. So are Urza's Sagas. Like, if you want to play a deck with those, it's just almost impossible to do it. Like, yeah. I think if you pay for the highest subscription from any of the rental services, you can't play four color. Which is fine.
But that's why we're here, chat. We're playing Paper Magic.
Yeah, true.
That's why we're here. I do enjoy Paper Magic a ton. I think it's a lot more enjoyable to play, too. Especially when you have somebody fun to, like, play with and you're, like, trolling a lot.
Legend but, Shredder is also is absurd. I agree with that.
Yeah, Shredder is also crazy.
It's, like, 60, isn't it, or something like that? Just get a Merc Todd. They play it.
Shredder's for a playset is 180 ticks.
Okay, it's not quite 60, but damn. Wow, Ragavan went down a ton, bro. What happened to that? I thought it used to be a lot more.
Dragon Rage Chandler is 2.7 ticks.
Yeah, Ragavan went down to 163 for fourth. Wow, he went down to 40. I thought he was way more than that. Shredders are just as expensive. Odawara. Ooh, that's a good one when Kai's Ghost forms on something. It just loses all the enchantments and it goes to hand. That is brutal.
Some would say TJ's good at this Magic the Gathering game, and I wouldn't get it.
He's at 400 shock.
You want to do Lock Totems?
Oh, yeah.
I realized that I haven't looked at this game once. We've just been talking about online formats. Yeah, Shredder is, like, really expensive, but, I mean, it's drastically different online than it is in paper.
Rag's like 65 right now.
Like, paper. It's $100 more for the entire playset. It's $80 for a playset now in paper, but online it's $100 an additional.
Yeah.
Which I feel like online should be where your card's cheaper, in my opinion.
I think so too. But I just wish Arena was better. I'd play it a lot more. I just don't want to grind something to play the deck I want to play.
Yeah, and Rag's limited to modern. That's true. You do get, your cards will always get more expensive whenever they're able to be played in multiple formats.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Where Rag is, like, trying to just survive in modern.
He is only in modern. He dropped a bulk if he got banned there, I believe. It'd stay a little bit up, because some commander decks probably play it, but... Yeah, what if Ragavan was your commander?
Yeah, one of the things that TJ brought up to me whenever he was, like, talking about playing on Arena... Just at 17, but he said the reason he likes MTGO is because he knows it's digital, but the way that the cards are set out and the way that they work is it makes it feel like he's playing a card game.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas like Arena feels more like Hearthstone-ish because you have like all these animations and stuff, and then like your cards don't necessarily go like in a line, like your land sometimes will like come back, like you got like different things in zones. If like you have cards in your graveyard that can be cast, they're actually like in your hand, but in a different spot.
Yeah.
Which is kind of like annoying, but.
Pretty sure Josh is just locked out at this point. He's talked like another light pause.
Wait, did he just put his lands on Kyle's table? What the fuck?
I don't know. TJ's been... Oh, it's a SRAM. That's actually...
TJ's in a trolling mood now. I'm pretty sure he tapped off his lands and set him on Kyle's mat.
I think he did, too.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Arena is a lot more, like, free and cheap, where you have to, like, have a rental service or pay a lot more to play, but... It is what it is. Wizards knows what they're doing. Right, guys?
Ma.
They haven't printed busted cards.
Chat, what's your most expensive card and expensive deck you put money in? Damien's is four color.
Yeah.
Mine is four color that is balled out. It is currently like barely over $2,100. Most expensive card being Probably Onslaught Flooded Strand at like $84. Yeah, for sure. That card.
I guess my commander deck was my most expensive deck.
Not mine.
My commander deck came out to like $2,600.
Mine was a little bit under that. That's cringe. Wait, did you have the Yogg-Swill though? You bought the Yogg-Swill, right? Or is that without it?
I was going to buy it and then I sold it like the next day and that was without it. But you got it, man. I've grabbed like every borderless card I could and stuff like that. I was playing like Cass or some shit like that. Is Modern not proxy friendly? It's a lot of green. No. If there are, Wizards doesn't really like the word proxies, but
no, they just that.
So I'm gonna use the phrase playtest cards. If you have a proxy slash playtest card in your deck, you cannot run the event as a sanctioned Wizards of the Coast event. Therefore, like if for example one of these players in their deck have a proxy card or playtest card, this event's not valid and we have to like close that event. But kitchen table, stuff like that, playing with the friends,
that's all fine.
I at first, like, I recommend that you actually print out the deck and play it before you buy it, especially a Modern one.
Yeah,
like don't try to take it to an event, play it in a store, but like try it somewhere. There are free applications so you can try it online. Having a Solitude on turn one.
Bro, I kept a one lander and I Solitude Ephemerated my opponent's Goblin Guide and then I hit him for 3 lifelink on my turn. Let me tell you what, that felt great.
So, TJ's up again. But
let's go, TJ.
Josh is already down to 16.
Look, it's the card freaking Kyle once banned.
Let's see if you get it this time.
Bro, that's 2 portable holes in a march.
Josh is already down to 16.
Yeah, that's bargers. Oh, 1-2 minute. It's okay. He's playing against blue-white control. Your life doesn't matter. Oh, no. It definitely can. But
yeah, that's why. It's because that deck, a lot of times, they're like fetching and shocking most of the time.
Yeah.
So, like, they're bolting themselves for...
Yeah.
I mean, for your 4th land drop, you've probably fetched 3 times. Is that
safe to say? I would try to fetch a basic if I could.
Right, but I'm just saying fetches alone. You've probably have fetched 3 times.
I'm probably fetching at least twice.
At the very minimum. So, like, yeah. If you fetch shock and then you find out your own burn and then you fetch and get a basic and your next 2 lands come in, whatever.
Yeah.
Like, you've taken 4 life.
Yeah.
And can't really do a whole lot about just getting hit in the face with a burn spell.
Well, that was the thing in game 2 when I had the one lender. I kept like 2 Solitudes, 2 Ephemerates, a Renin 6, and a Hallowed Fountain. And I kept it and I won. Because my opponent.
That's what I'm talking about, babe.
What?
He plays Sultai Infect, which I would assume that means Phyrexian Crusaders in that.
I'd crush that deck.
You can't. Can you kill Phyrexian Crusader?
Is that the black one with pro red white?
I think so. It might not be.
Is red. It?
I know it has protection from white.
I think it has protection from red though. P H Y R E.
I would say it's on here. I don't know what I try to spell out. Yeah. So we're talking about, if you don't know, we're talking about this.
I eat it with Risen Reef.
Yeah, you're right. My bad.
I triple block.
Yeah.
I do have Coatl. No, Coatl can't get it because that's first strike.
Yeah,
I actually have nothing. I just lose to that card.
Yeah, this card has I'm surprised it had to
it
come
can't,
up.
It can chump, you're right, it can chump, which is probably the important part.
Yeah, because you're just like...
Because they go to pump it up and you're like, okay, cool, I'm going to chump it with Coatl.
And then hopefully you have something in 5 turns.
What?
Talking about Phyrexian Crusader during our Pioneer the Gathering event.
Yeah, where's our impact creatures in Pioneer, honestly? Oh, I'm just kidding. I would never want that.
Yeah, and Taren also makes a good point.
Oh, yeah, like, I have Dress down, too.
Taren also makes a good point in terms of, like, Omnath life gain is not till turn 5.
Yeah, no, it's... Well, that's not true if you have Risen Reef.
I mean, sure, but...
Because that's how I won game 3. I had Risen Reef, and I was able to turn 4 get Omnath with the life gain.
Yeah, Endurance, Dress down...
Oh, wait, I have Endurance, too. Yeah, I'm trolling.
But, like, it's still not an easy card for you. You have to, like...
I play 5 copies.
You have to, like, remove it in a weird way.
I have 5 copies. You
have to remove it in a decent, easy way.
Yeah, I play Elemental.
Manalup.
What do you think I'm playing, dude? I play the good version.
Manalup. Next to the fall. Appreciate.
Yeah, call for a Meddling Mage. No, I need to put Meddling Mage in my sideboard. It's really good against a lot of the Cascade decks.
Listen, you can't talk about Damien about anything. He always has it.
Yeah, I do.
He always has it.
I went through the Get Good training of Magic Gathering, and I have everything. What?
He's a guaranteed lock for ninth place.
I don't understand why my opponents scoop when I have 3 Risen Reefs and then I cast an Omnath. I don't get it.
Or a Yorioth.
I don't get it.
I'm just
trying to have fun. And they said no.
Did I tell you what Dylan did during the tournament? And his opponent decided it was time to get up. He played a Yorion with like an Omnath in play, 2 Risen Reefs, and 2 Ice Fang Quaddles, and like 2 Abundant Growths.
I hope
like,
he did.
He's like, flicker my Yorion. And we're like, please, opponent, pick it up.
You're not. Sometimes winning. I'll tell my opponents, I'm like, you can concede.
Or your good evening legends. Yo, I like the gas, bro.
Yeah, that's what I'm about. I like it. We're having a great time in here.
I hope you're having a good evening.
We are having a good time out here.
I really do. That's some goated comments right there. TJ's at 23. Josh is at 18. And we still don't have our life setters right.
Rick, I want you to build Elemental so we can just literally have fun playing Risen Reef. I won't even attack you. I'll let your Risen Reefs live the entire time.
It's like, who can mill themselves
for I say we do that. That would be sick.
Did he fail to find?
He might have. He has 2 basics out. He might only play those.
That's a big feels bad.
Yeah, that is a big feel bad.
That
strip mine.
TJ is fist pumping if that's faith.
TJ just needs to play. Do you know that like Crucible Worlds is just legal in Pioneer? I want to play Land Destruction with that card.
Did he not shuffle? I'm going to be honest, chat. I haven't watched this game. It got real bad there for a while. How many players tonight? We have 10. Had 10. We had 2 drop because they were 0-2. But we had 10, so 4 rounds. Yeah, I was going to say, I don't... Like, oh, no. Of course it shuffles, but, like, the deck's still randomized. Like, my man's in the gutter right now, dude. I'm not stopping it.
Poor guy.
My man's in the gutter right now, dude. He just...
Yeah, it's a buy for blue-white. It's not good for
this isn't great.
Because what Auras wants to see is like a thing.
Call the fight.
They want to see
somebody got
what happened?
Throw the flag, dude. Call the fight. It's over.
Yeah. Where's the white flag?
My man Josh getting a hell of a left hook right now.
Totem armor seems real bad. There's no totem armor in Pioneer, is there?
I think some of those do.
I don't think so.
Any game watchers? I'll check. Yeah. I don't know, man. Sometimes it's just more fun to talk to chat and focus on the game, you know?
Yeah, we talk to them about our favorite game of Magic the Gathering, and then sometimes when something crazy happens, we go crazy.
Also, it's a lot more exciting to watch if it doesn't feel super one-sided like it's feeling right now.
Yeah, we just flash back a Deluge.
Yeah, we're just gonna get a lot more cards.
Yeah, we're gonna raid... him?
Yeah. Why not? Oh, speaking of Meddling Mage.
Oh, look at that.
What is this man playing? He's playing Affinity right now.
I hope he is. He should be playing a better deck. Like 4 color.
Auras is in a weird spot because I felt like Light Pulse was going to make this deck insane, and
it just doesn't.
They're still behind all the time.
Well, against Blue White, they have a lot of exiling effects. So even if they go get like Kaya's ghost form or whatever, like they just go, okay, exile your card and then it goes away.
What do you think it's like? Do you think it's kind of one of those issues where like Bogles, for example, the creatures have hexproof, where here, like, them not having hexproof, so they're always able, they're always like vulnerable, kind of?
Yeah, like, that's the reason that, like, it's sometimes, like, okay in Modern is, like, they have hexproof, but, like, they just get to kill them.
I feel like that has to be an issue. It's because they're just never safe. Like, even you playing a creature to, like, sacrifice it to protect your creature for one turn doesn't feel very, like, doesn't feel great ever, I think.
Yeah, no, it doesn't. It's got to feel pretty bad.
Cannon combo? Yo, let's go! I'm always hyped to hear cannon combo.
It's pretty.
The amount of times I've showed my stream and just in historic, like cycling chromatic stars or spheres or whatever one's legal in historic,
mm-hmm.
when playing like cannon combo with Paradox Engine, I don't know what version you're playing, but I was playing Paradox Engine in historic because they gave me cool cards to play with, so I did it.
Four color and pioneer equals Jeskai Ascendancy. I'm fine with this. Bro, that deck died. It lost Express Federation.
Are you Paradox? Are you Song of Creation? Alright, you really got me hyped up right now. I'm curious to see which one you played. Paradox Engine? I'd say the decks are like exactly the same. We just got Chromatic Sphere in that format. But yo, that'd be sick. I'm in the Discord as Shadowmare, so you can send it there. I'd be down to look at it. I'd build that in paper.
Well, I'm gonna play four color tonight on MTGO.
No, we're talking about Paradox Engine.
I'll play that one too.
And Pioneer.
Let's see who gets more dubs with it, Brick. You or me?
I played Ascendancy, and yeah, this game was over. But
yeah, this game's 100% over.